The Nokia 3310 and its legendary snake game are back. It's 2017 and one of Nokia's newest phones is a blast from the past. It's time to open it up and review it from the inside and see what makes it so durable. Let's get started. It's quite refreshing to pop off the back of the phone and see a removable battery and some exposed screws. After taking apart so many water-resistant, glued-shut phones lately, this is a welcome sight. The exterior back panel is very securely clasped around the plastic frame, and then there are six T5 screws holding the midframe to the front panel. After those screws are out, there's another series of six clasps holding the midframe in place. All of these little secure contact points help keep the phone structurally solid. On the back of that white midframe, we have the flash with its two golden contact points for the motherboard, and the loudspeaker for those luscious snake game sounds we were listening to earlier. The motherboard is pretty simple all by itself. The micro USB charging port is soldered onto the frame up at the top. I'll unsnap the screen ribbon cable like a little Lego, and then the whole motherboard is free from the frame. The 2-megapixel camera's next. This cute little guy has another Lego-like connector, and it's also clamped in place by a little metal bracket, but it's still totally replaceable. It does not have OIS, but at this price point, I don't think any of us expected it to. I'm just happy that the 3310 has a camera. Now that the camera's all clipped back into place, the headphone jack is down there at the bottom, soldered on, along with the battery contact points. Flipping the board around shows us the brains of the keypad with its own little ribbon connector. These also have the backlit LEDs that light up the front buttons. The phone is pretty modular. The SIM and SD card trays are not removable though. Above them, we find the notification vibrator for the Nokia 3310. It's rather small compared to the older version of the phone. The older Nokia 3310 had a vibrator at least three times this size. These little spinny bits are called an eccentric rotating mass vibrator. And while bigger rotating masses will cause a stronger vibration, the smaller vibrator will still get the job done. I'll talk more about vibrators in a different video, since there are quite a few different kinds out there. The keypad falls away from the front of the phone easy enough. Definitely no water resistance anywhere, but the screen itself is very heavily glued in place on that front panel. Surprise, surprise. It can't be removed without a hot plate or a high temperature heat gun, which is pretty standard in how most durable phones are constructed these days. Adhesive on the screen is a pretty important and essential part of the construction process. I'll set the motherboard back into place and clip that midframe back on to secure it, and finally get the six T5 screws back in place. The older Nokia 3310 used a T6 bit, so Nokia did drop down a screw size, so while the whole phone is entirely made of plastic, its small form factor, thick layers all sandwiched, screwed, and clasped together, make for quite a solid little brick. I would not be surprised to see this phone last until the next remake of the phone in another 17 years from now. Do you wish more phones had removable batteries, or do you prefer the water-resistant trend that we have going on right now? Let me know down in the comments. And come hang out with me on Twitter and Instagram. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.